Yeah. I'm surprised if they are. Yes, Corby got the ball from Jordan Watson.
Sean Reed does well there. Now he's really down the chance. Maguire through one and one.
Oh, he's got a chance.
Can he finish?
Yes! Goal! Get in, Dan Maguire.
Did well. Did so, so well.
Sean Reed demonstrating why he's playing in the centre midfield today. Going in well on a strong 50-50 and playing the ball straight through for Maguire. Maguire faced by Aidan Grant, sorry, in the Corby goal. Grant tried to go down and bring Maguire down, but Maguire just jinks around him and fires it into the back of the net. 1-0 Blyth. Daidlaw with a nice little touch off the outside of his boot. And again, picks it up as he drives through the midfield. Oh, a nice touch there by Armstrong, and Maguire's into the box.
If he can keep it in.
Does well, outside of his foot.
Oh!
Seems to be twice as slow as well.
Yeah,
Phil Trainer does well. Shoots on a tight angle, but it's found a side netting. But
deflected somewhere, or did Wilson get a hand to it? It was a rocket shot. I thought it went straight to the side netting.
Looks long for Luke Armstrong. Armstrong bulged in the back, but again, the referee sees nothing. Oh, and that's a fantastic goal.
Correcting goal.
Stephen Moore there, about the best part of 40 yards out. Turns, hits a ball on the volley, that flies in the top corner. Nothing Woolston could really do about that, but from Bly's point of view, Luke Armstrong is barged in the back from the throw.
He was.
And the referee doesn't give anything, and then that happens. A little bit more urgency now from Blyth. Not often that they're used to being pegged back, as recent games have gone on. Sean Reed flicks on a long throw. Jack Rivers just can't find his feet. Great turn by Armstrong. And now Crawford comes forward, gets around Atkinson, and is able to find Phil Trainer. Phil Trainer puts the ball down the line for Stephen Moore. It comes to Ben Mills on the edge of the box. Oh, and then the follow-up there. It was a fantastic block there by Jordan Watson, and the follow-up by Connor Kennedy drifts wide of the far post as well. Atkinson, a bit of a loose touch, and then his ball in field isn't the best, but Hutchinson
bounces
forward as well. Finds Maguire, turns, tries to get away, and is right. Dive and save there by Aidan Grant. Ball's back in Blyth's half now as Jordan Watson finds Robbie Deal. Robbie Deal, who's been quite quiet the second half, turns away from two men, but is eventually blocked out by the third and fourth. Now the ball's back with Robbie Deal. Deal puts a cross in. Oh! Half chance. Goal!
Jordan Reed took his time. Steered it past Grant beyond his right-hand side, low into the net. Would you say Grant's fault possibly for that goal, Sam? He went to
I think
cross or palmed it rather weakly, felt to... Well, almost three Blyth players, but it was Sean Reed who got there first.
But now Rivers picks the ball up. Atkinson's in support. Now Atkinson drives in field with the ball. Still going. Now Robbie Deal has good yardage to run into. Cuts inside one. Back out onto his left foot. Drew tries to chip.
Massive performance by Robbie Dale and finished by Dan Maguire.
Yep, Dan Maguire there, the head in his second goal of the game. Makes it 3-1 to Blyth, but credit has to go there to Robbie Dale. Went one way then the other, stood the ball up. This time Grant isn't able to get anything on the ball, and Robbie Dale's cross is met by the header, Dan Maguire. Jarrett Rivers, who's came more into the game.
That's a neat goal.
Rivers does well, puts a cross in. Luke Armstrong gets across his mark and is able to flick the ball in at the far post. Blyth definitely running away with the game now as they hit four goals. Rivers driving forward.
Just for Rivers.
Rivers.
Oh! Scoops it.
Ball's floated forward. Oh, it's missed, and Yaka Fano was able to pounce on it. Well, just as I was saying that the game appeared to be over, it's Corby have half a lifeline, I suppose. McTiernan now finds Mullen, and Patterson. The referee blows the final whistle there.